A very warm good evening to everyone. Ma'am, first of all, my high regards to you and to you, Barkha Ma'am.
Namaskar.
To everyone here, I mean, as a woman, as being here as a host is a privilege because I have grown up talking to both of them in multiple various aspects. Barkha Ma'am has been an inspiration and Sonal Ma'am is inspiration to the nation, to be honest, when I say this. And it is very safe to say that I was literally shivering when I got to know that I will be getting an honor to be on board with both of you. Before anything and everything that I have prepared, I just want to pay my absolute regards and respect to both of you with deepest of my hearts and my existence. So I open the session and welcome to one and all. Today it is a privilege to be here because Orange City Literature Festival, I can still remember the last time when it took place in 2019. The entire team was working and we were not really sure. I mean, literature is important, we all know. But then at the same time, looking at the mainstream media, we often kind of have apprehensions, you know, how many people will turn out, how many people will show interest. But the overwhelming response was enough for us to know that even if anything goes wrong in 2020, we are not backing off. And this year, we are back with our second edition. And honestly, as much as you can see four people on the screen right now, but there is an entire team who is behind with the internet, IT infrastructure, and everybody, and most importantly, the viewers who are watching this. So I'll right away start with you, like today. That was like all forms of cultural expression reflects the society in which we exist. It has many purposes. It can include expression. It can include communication. It can include education, therapy, recreation, entertainment, and may function in personal, political, social, religious, and spiritual environments. You never know in what sense will it make difference to you or how deeply will it impact you. Okay, so welcome to the second special session of the evening. Padma Vibhushan and Dr. Sonal Man Singh in conversation with Ms. Barkha Mathur, where they're going to be breaking boundaries, dance, culture, and society. It's going to be an evening of absolute repertoire. A magic spell, time-tested and trusted belief, because when two esteemed personalities come on stage, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, all you can expect is just how important confidence can be. But at the same time, knowing your skill, knowing your craft, being in that trade for years together can make a difference. I'm presenting to you Dr. Sonal Man Singh. She's the first recipient of Padma Vibhushan in 2003 from Sri APJ Abdul Kalam and Padma Bhushan in 1992 from Sri R. Venkatraman. Prime Minister of India, Sri Narendra Modi, nominated her also as a number one for Swachh Bharat Mission. She was nominated by President of India to Rajya Sabha, the upper house of Indian Parliament, in July 2018, in recognition of her lifelong dedication and service to India's land. A unique contribution has been her lifelong work using her knowledge to address socio-cultural issues through the chosen medium of dance as a soloist, teacher, choreographer, and a motivational speaker. As the founder president of Sri Kamakhya Kalapi Center for Indian Classical Dancers, which was established in Delhi in 1977, she has trained 7,000 talented students who are carrying the message of Indian culture globally. She teaches the art as a holistic concept, combining music, yoga, Sanskrit, and cultural traditions of India. And in rendezvous with her is yet another iconic personality of Nagpur. She's an author, sub-editor, presenter, and a great follower of art, skill, and culture. And a senior journalist. What is actually a hobby for most of us, it's her work. She writes about cultural events and artists. And to honestly, when I saw her work, I understood one thing very clearly. She does not leave it at just performances. She wants a bit to write about their struggles, achievements, and changing trends, how it has been from the past to the new time. Presently, to me, she just represents sway of grace and sophistication. I was in conversation with her when she told me it was Sonal Ma'am only whom she had first interview with. So all I can say is life is a piece as an individual. Honestly, this is my pure joy and blessing to present before you Ms. Barkha Mathur in discussion with our very own Dr. Sonal Ma'am Singh. Over to you, Barkha Ji.
Thank you very much, Priyanka. It's a very, very nice, very warm, and a very exuberant kind of an introduction that you gave to us. Thank you very much, ma'am. Namaskar. And namaskar. It's an honor to be in conversation with you today. As Priyanka rightly said, I began my journalist career when I interviewed first at a Spic Mec Lake Dam in Lucknow, way back. So life comes full circle and we are here today. And ma'am, as you are aware, the conversation will revolve around breaking boundaries in the sphere of dance, culture and society. And for the audience, I would like to say that there can be no better person to discuss this or to speak on these subjects more than Sonalji, an artist who has used her craft not just to train future artists, but has also employed her dancing skills to make a statement on the changing social scenario. Ma'am, if I were to ask you, do you think India, the society in India, has kept pace with the changes that are taking place all around, you know, in terms of the cultural changes, the thought processes, the manner in which we conduct our art and culture today? You think the society, the art, we are keeping pace, arts is keeping pace with it?
Can I put it the other way around? Do you think society has kept pace with the arts?
Okay, that's
sure. Because in India, I think we do believe that arts are the soul, the spirit, the soul, the identity of a civilization, of society. And Indian arts have a very different ethos, therefore. True. Very different ethos from the, say, European, American, other countries. And I feel that certain things don't change. They should not change. Things that are the core values, the core principles, the core concepts, the way we look at life, the way we look at, cosmos, from mini to mega.
True.
Society evolves at its own pace. Sometimes it seems to be on a plateau. But I think art has never been on a plateau.
Yeah.
And therefore, I think that we keep saying, oh, it's so old, it's ancient art, it's 5,000 years old, 2,000 years old. I don't want to get into the time frame. All I'm saying is that is why perhaps arts are still vibrant. They still are saying something to people. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, I think we'd all have been redundant long ago.
True.
And
true.
So I've turned your question around according to my understanding, the way I look at it. The question for me as an artist is, has society in India kept pace with the beauty, aesthetics, principles, concepts of art?
Yeah.
The question is for you.
Is actually for the society, ma'am, but there's one more thing which I'll just continue with this question. If what I want to know is, ma'am, performing arts has taken some kind of a beating in terms of, you know, shrinking audiences. There is a lack of time, there is a lack of venues, performance venues. So do you think all these factors are contributing that you are having lesser shows, people, audiences are less involved, or maybe the younger generation is getting to see a less of it now, you know, because of these pressures that have come up, you know, especially in the cities, etc., where we had these shows?
I won't use the harsh word taken a beating. I would say that I'd rather say that the, as you yourself mentioned, the changing societal needs, even not needs, the shrinking families, atomic families, job profiles, job-oriented life for young students, getting grades. Unfortunately, it's, you know, that oriented education. And then, of course, the greatest factor contributing to that is the ever-developing technological, you would call them advances. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure if I would call them advances. in one, everything has a pros and cons, no? Two sides of the coin. So while they do connect you to the world, as if we were not connected earlier, but never mind. they connect you to larger, I mean, so much information. We know this, there's overload of information. And the variety of platforms available, the variety of handles, the variety of yantras available. Now, all that becomes very confusing to a normal person. I think artists are a little abnormal, or I shall say extra normal, not abnormal, extra normal. So many things contribute today that if you can sit at home and switch on television, or not even television, you can switch on your laptop or your mobile phone and look at so many things at your will, in your own space and time. And you don't want to get into the hurly-burly of traffic congestions.
Absolutely. Commuting.
So, yes, I think so. These kind of changes, which have everything to do with the modern amenities, modern conditions.
Correct.
But still, yet I would say that there are so many, I get emails and messages and WhatsApp and general, kab program shuru honge? When can we come to go to Kamani and watch you, ma'am? Isme maza nahi aa raha. You know? So that is also there. The immediacy, the warmth, the connection, the communication, the waves.
Correct.
Energy. You connect. All that is missing. And I think a large section of people feels that, even the youngsters, mind you. At any given time, they would prefer to go to Habitat or Kamani or any other auditorium rather than sit at home and watch in that little screen.
Which is a compulsion.
Compulsion of the pandemic now.
<I know.
laughs> It has been a great sort of, you know, kate kuthara ghat. It's sort of, it has axed away the normalcy.
True.
Which was a very beautiful way that things were happening. Society, the arts, the artists, the connections, the different way of looking. All that, you know, is at a standstill. But still, the other side is, because of that, we are able to reach many more people through this medium.
That's a positive side of it. Yeah, true.
Yeah, but you can't see the all of me. You only have to be content with this much.
I'm sure even so, you won't be, if somebody was to ask you to perform like this, you would hate it absolutely, you know.
Darling, I performed. I performed my Natya Katha like this. And they were in tears. So one has to really let go of inhibitions and put all your energy and your soul on that screen. So the screen is the via media.
Yes. Done. Ma'am, one more thing has happened. And these fusion enthusiasts, you know, they are experimenting with dance forms now. And dancing, they are projecting as something to keep healthy and fit. I mean, how would a classical dancer like you and many more of your fraternity, how would you react to this kind of a portrayal of dancing, you know, that, okay, let's indulge in dancing, let's get you on the dance floor, because it keeps you fit.
Any which way, come to dancing.
That's a very nice way of putting it.
Yeah. Any which way. You dance to keep healthy, you dance to keep supple, you dance to look beautiful, you dance to gain grace and power, you dance to attract suitors, you dance.
Oh, you don't mind
that. What I'm saying is basically that these kind of notions that, oh, the fusion is always confusion, I say things have happened. They will keep happening. That which has some substance will last. Others, like bubbles, will rise and again subside.
True.
Let it happen. Let it happen.
You okay with this, you know, too much of westernization of Indian dance forms, you know, fusing them.
No, what do you mean by that? No, no, hello, 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 hello. Excuse me. What do you mean by westernization? I have never understood that word now.
What is that word? You shows your perspective, ma'am. If you're when you say this, it shows how broad your perspective is. But what I meant actually was the beat, you know, the beats, you know, dancing all the time on these fast-paced music, the beats, etc. And you know, it's somewhere it puts into shadows the more classical Indian instrumentation that is traditional, which goes with the Indian dance forms. You know, it's all electronic, if we may say so.
Yeah, now you come from dance to instruments on music. Let me first deal with dance.
Okay, yeah.
Okay? Mm-hmm. With music, somehow, it has started long ago. With Ravi Shankar, with so many others who followed him. And even his elder brother, Uday Shankar, who danced with Anna Pavlova, the greatest ballerina of her times.
True.
And it was my mother who saw Anna Pavlova and Uday Shankar partnering her, especially in dances called Radha Krishna, going back from Australia to America, and they stopped in Bombay. I'm talking of 1943-44. Okay. And my mother was pregnant. And she said, whatever this child is, let it dance. And I was born.
Ooh.
And I had no, as I keep saying, I had no choice but to dance. Now, at that time also, a ballet and something Indian, that was called Oriental dance or the Hindu dance, it was happening. With dance, I think it's more difficult. In Kathak, it's happening. It's been happening all along. But westernization applies to, I think, more where b-boying and breakdance and contemporary, and the Martha Graham. But Martha Graham was great. So here it is more of the imitation of what you call Western dance, more American, not more European. It's all America.
Yeah, it happens.
But I don't think it has made great inroads. Rather, they are going after the Bollywoodian. Bollywood.
Yeah.
And Indian traditional dance is neither this nor that.
True.
It has maintained its own place.
Yeah. And it's true. Ma'am. Women dominate Indian dancing, classical dancing, especially if we may say so. So the list of Indian classical dancers mostly comprises of women. And so the themes also have been women-centric, ma'am. Most of the themes, you know, when you take up, I mean, when you plan a ballet or something. So do you think these, you know, the themes are women empowerment, atrocities on women. So has it made an impact on the society? Does it come across and impact the thinking of the people when the artists pick up these themes to, you know, speak, give a social message through their craft? Does it have an impact?
Long question. There are two or three sub-questions there.
Sure.
One, the assumption that Indian classical dancers are women-oriented. The entire Kathakali belonged to male dancers till very recently. That's one. Kathak dance also majorly was male-oriented because of the Mughal courts and all. And the women as gurus or great dancers emerged much later. Now, then we have Manipuri. Manipuri, which is equally male-female because of the nature of its Lai Haroba and the Vaishnavite.
Okay.
Then I come to Kuchipuri. No, I'll come slowly
Okay.
to Odissi, don't worry. I come to Kuchipudi. Kuchipudi from the Kuchipudi village, Kuchelapuram, and Kuchela is the name for Sudama, Krishna's friend. In South India, he's called Kuchela. So the poor Brahmins who were dancers, nutters, musicians were given villages and lands, and therefore they were Kuchelas, they were like Sudama, they were poverty stricken, they were poor. And the kings and the Nayakas gave them villages and lands. So Kuchipudi is Apabhramsha of Kuchelapuram, and Kuchipudi then becomes the dance style. Now that was also male oriented because it's actually a full night dance drama. The Bhagavatas used to perform, and the women came much later. I come to then Bharatanatyam, no, Mohiniyattam from Kerala. That is the only style which is totally feminine, female. Not one male dancer has dared to don Mohiniyattam costume and dance Mohiniyattam. That's the only one. We come to Bharatanatyam. Bharatanatyam, again, the gurus were all male till late. If you look at the sculptures, yes, the dancers, the model was a woman, generally. But the karanas, you know, the 108 dance postures which are famous from Bharatanatyam Shastra, which are on the temple walls at Chidambaram, Kumbhakonam, and Vriddhachalam, and it will come, Arunachalam. They are all female figures. But Shiva, the male dancer, is in Tanjore Brihadeeswara temple. Last is Odissi, which sort of was rediscovered in 50s. And the temple sculptures also show female, and if the male dancer is there, it is like a musician or a partner. Why I say this is that naturally the female form is so attractive. Nature has made her so. And then the Indian woman is not like the European or American woman. We have a different bone structure. Our body is different. They are, you know, the bosom, the waist, the hips, the way the arm falls like a severed, half severed branch of a tree, or like the flow of an elephant trunk. Now, most of these people who come from abroad, especially the West, they have, even the bodies are
Stiff.
straight. I won't call them stiff,
Straight.
straight. So they look very nice in jeans and shirts and t-shirts, whereas an Indian woman has broad and she looks a little awkward unless she really goes to gym and works it out, but the natural. So the women are made by nature in India. They are beautiful, they are graceful, and the bodies lend themselves to the dance forms that evolved around them. Now, you can't fault women for that.
Not at all, not at
And
all.
usually they say the male dancer, unless it's a dance drama, you can't look at a solo male dancer for more than 20 minutes. He always needs a partner, a female partner. Kya karega? Aisa hai. It's so. Then you have asked about the social issues pertaining to
The themes
women,
managed, women,
pertaining to
empowerment,
women. Yeah, yeah, yeah,
atrocities
yeah,
on.
yeah. Again, atrocities and, you know, ayo Bhagwati, this is such a chabaya hua issue, question.
Ma'am, if I wanted to.
Injustice to women.
Ma'am, Draupadi
Injustice.
continues to dominate these ballets.
Injustice to women, I would come to that. Injustice, I use the word, to women because of a gender is rampant Again, you don't say I'm apologetic. I'm not apologetic. I'm just saying it's rampant throughout centuries in the world. Show me one country where it does not exist.
Absolutely.
It's the male psyche, A, and then according to the civilizational, traditional values that are imbibed, you be good. And then the historical issues we should not forget. Countries like India, which have been again and again attacked by people who did not believe in women's independence or her beauty or the aesthetics or whatever. So women had to cover. Women started covering. Women had to commit Johar. There are many such details which combine to create this whole issue of atrocities, injustices done to women. Artists have a huge responsibility in pointing out every issue, not just women's, but children, nature, ecological imbalance, respect towards each other. So many things.
Yeah.
Coming to women again, I think at least I have seen quite a few artists. I myself have created many choreographies on women.
True.
My Natya Katha, which I started in 2009, Natya Katha Stri, Draupadi, Panchakanya, my solo dance theater Draupadi, in 1994. Before that, so many others. I mean, I have naturally come to this. Nobody had to tell me, because what we learned from gurus were the margams, were the beauty of the poetry, beauty of tradition, beauty of form. But today's artists, we are all educated. We see the world, we see around us. We feel the pain, the sorrow, the disrespect, and as artists, as a responsible citizen, as a thinking person, as a feeling person, you say, what can I do about this? What can I do about this?
Yeah.
So I do it through my art, I do it through my poetry, through my speeches, through my katha, through my performances, and through articles, through interaction. I don't leave 1 minute without talking about not only women, but today, Papa, Mama, hi, hello, hi, yo, baby, yo. Amma. No, listen, hello, I'm coming to this disrespect. Ma, Amma, Ba, Babuji, Pitaji, Bapuji, in our own languages, Appa, Amma, we have given that up. When you give up the key, the core words which express the values, the respect, then what happens? Then what happens? So I see connections all around. I see connections everywhere. And I tell people again and again, come back to the words. Are you usme kya hai? Papa bol diya. Oh my God, usi mein to sab kuch hai. Everything is there. Why do you have to say papa? When it is not your language, when it is not your culture, when you are not born of that soil, you are born here. Pitaji, what does it mean? Pita. Matru Devo Bhava, we don't say Mammi Devo Bhava. Pitru Devo Bhava, we don't say Papa Devo Bhava. Guru Devo Bhava, we don't say Yo Devo Bhava. So I feel that we need to really look at so many things when we talk of one issue. It's not one issue. There are layers. There are threads.
True, true.
And I like to always talk about these because we usually forget.
Ma'am, as you may be observing in the society, I am now moving away from the art and dance forms. A lot is happening in our society today, you know, and artists are very evolved people, you know. Their perceptions, their opinions are valued, and so are required to make a comment on things which may be unrelated to you also. Not only in India, across the world now, ma'am, we are seeing that this radicalism is rising somehow. And obviously, the thing is, you know, a journalist like me would like to reach out to an artist to get an opinion on this. So what do you say, ma'am, in today's climate, I mean, would you say that it's an artist should be politically correct? Or would you say that it's good to express yourself and an artist should always freely express, because somewhere they are the sentinels of the society. They are the one, they are the moral keepers of the society. The thought process goes through them, you know. So how would you say it? Or is it okay? I will be politically safe and correct and I will say what is required of me.
I want to remind you of your second question,
yeah,
or third, when you said artists and art have taken a beating.
Absolutely.
Now you're saying the opposite. That thought processes go through artists.
Yeah, I am.
So which one is no, no. So let us come.
That question was, ma'am, about the number of shows of performing arts that are taking place, the dwindling numbers, you know, which are coming down due to, as we discussed, traffic, commuting, time
yeah,
shortages.
Yeah. But that was one aspect. The second aspect, because then, you know, the confusion, the fusion, that does this art need something more than what it is? That is how I understood the question. But I didn't take it up because it would be too long. Art has taken a beating in terms of, as you said, all this statistics, number of performances, this, that. The other part of it is that art has taken a beating. Has it taken a beating? Because it does not measure up to today's demands of something new every day. That was my question in my mind.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. And for that, I think we have come to other things, that something in art is perennial, something in art is eternal, Shashwat, Sanatan. Yeah.
Absolutely.
What it, the messages are for all times. The messages, if we fail to understand, we fail to read messages contained within our art forms. I'll give you my very favorite example, river pollution today, in India, everywhere, and so many countries. The Third World War may be on drinking water, not on oil or gas.
Yeah.
The story in Srimad Bhagavat, Sri Krishna jumping into Yamuna, fighting with Kaliya, who had created pollution, and asking to get away. Pollution gone. Aha, so we show it in dance and all that, but unless I connect it to today. And my question always is to my audiences, who will be Krishna today? The Supreme Court, the government, or the society? This is how I tell you that it differs from the Western concept of art, whether it is contemporary or whether it's a classical ballet of the West. Our art...
Oh my God. How beautifully you have threaded it. I'm still getting over it. Very nicely put.
So, you know, yeah, no, but this is how I look at it, ma. And that is why even the stories of Mahishasura Mardini, the Durga,
yeah,
that the respect for women as the creator who protects. Arey bhai, any man does not get pregnant. It's always a woman. 9 months she protects the new life within her body. Within her body, inside. And she goes through so many situations. She can't turn over, she can't bend, she can't sleep. She feels uneasy. And with what pain, labor pain, she delivers the new life. And how she nurtures the new life.
Yes.
Then that is the strength of woman. And therefore we say Matru Devo Bhava. Therefore we worship Devi, the feminine, the cosmic feminine. And we are all a part of that. Even the men are part of that. Why? Why? Somebody asked me, why don't you come to Ajmer, that dargah of some great peer? And I said, I don't go anywhere except to Kamakhya. Acha, ye kya hai? It's a temple of Devi, Shakti Peeth, in Assam, Guwahati. For me, the mother is everything. He said, oh, then can I go with you? Bulawa. I said, there is no bulawa phulawa. Mother's doors are always open for children. And we are all her children. Anytime her doors are open. Now, this is the strength of woman. If we fail to read the messages in our so-called legends, Purana, that which happened long ago, but it is in collective memory. And why is it in collective memory is because those situations happen again and again. And the solutions are there, which we fail to read.
Good, true. Absolutely. Ma'am, you yourself have led me to this next question. Now, India is a very secular country, you will know, and we believe in equality of all, you know, and equal opportunities to everybody. But there is also no denying this fact that, ma'am, over the last decade or even more, we don't see many minorities like Muslims or Christians or other people who are, you know, coming into the Hindustani classical music or dancing streams. I mean, they're not taking it up. Do you feel there is something wrong happening here? What is it that stops them? Or these dance forms, they don't relate with it. What is the issue here, ma'am? Like Hindustani classical music, we have had so many Muslims pursuing it, but now we don't have. What could be the reason for this, ma'am?
Nee, how do you say classical music, Hindustani especially, has so many Muslim instrumentalists? You want me to take names?
Ma'am, Gaiki. If I Gaiki. गाने के लिए वोकलिस्ट इफ आई से
वोकलिस्ट हैं बहुत सारे हैं गुलाम मुस्तफा खान है और वो रशीद खान है और भी लोग हैं
पिछले 10 सालों में
सी यू कैन नो नो हेलो यू कांट फोर्स एनीवन दे आर टेकिंग इंस्ट्रूमेंट देयर आर सो मेनी इंस्ट्रूमेंटलिस्ट लाइक उस्ताद अमजद अली खान लाइक अवर शाहिद परवेज यू नो उस्ताद शाहिद परवेज एंड सो मेनी अदर्स
Yeah.
So maybe in another 10 years we'll have more Wasifuddin Dagar. The entire Dagar Gharana is Muslim. And they are all Dagar Mani, you know, Veena and singing, Dhrupad and Dhamar. Yeah. Bismillah Khan. So, I leave music out. I talk about dance.
Okay.
I'll tell you why. Dance is a physical art. It's a very different thing. And in among Sanatani, I don't call myself Hindu, I'm a Sanatani.
Right.
I follow Sanatana Dharma.
Okay. Correct.
In Sanatana Dharma, body is the temple. Sharir Mandir hai. And within the temple, there's a living God, which we call Chetana, Chitta Shakti.
Okay.
Which you call the soul, the spirit. Prana Shakti, simple. When Prana Shakti leaves you, you are dead. Okay? So body is the temple. And this body is offered in temples as offering to the great spirit, the Paramatma, whoever.
Absolutely.
That is the philosophy that informs Indian dances, whether they are folk dances or traditional dances or martial dances. Till today, nobody wears shoes on stage. Till today, everybody does pranam to the stage.
Yes.
Till today, everybody prays before dancing.
Yes.
Why is that? Now, in the other religions, mainly the ones you mentioned, this is not done. The body is sin.
Yes.
In another one, the woman's body is haram. It's only to be used, utilized, and thrown. The concepts are very different. Ma, try to understand. The philosophy, the concepts, the ideas, the way, the perceptions are totally like South Pole and North Pole.
So they'll never.
So yeah, you understand now. And then the physical beauty, yeah, this physicality of the woman, the dancer, whether it's male or female, we offer it. Our worship is conveyed through our body. There it is something different. Here we pray to Krishna, to Ganesh, to Devi, to Shiva. Who? That is totally haram.
But you would that, object to this form
there,
being
no, but there are the listen, there are hello ma, there are a few Muslim boys. One came to me also. I taught him some Bharatanatyam. Now he's doing some Kuchipudi and all that. Kali, you know, he's very happy doing that.
Mm-hmm.
There are, I think, at least half a dozen Muslim dancers, and there are more in Kathak.
Okay.
Because Kathak does not demand all this bhakti thing. That is how the Mughal courts wanted to see. Just the nritya, tatkar, chakras, amar, tukra. But as I said, the basics are so different. The perceptions are so different. There is no, we don't close doors on anyone. All are welcome. But you have to come now. You have to come.
And you would say it's wrong, you know, to identify this dance form with a religion or to say that, nahi, ye Hinduo ke hi karne ka hai. That would be, that's a very narrow view. Would you say that, ma'am?
The word religion upsets me. I said, yeah. I'm a Sanatani.
True.
That which is perennial, the values, understandings, everything that happens. When, as I said, when you say Krishna, who's Krishna? Who's Shiva? Krishna was a man, a historical figure. And yet the divinity of a perfect human being, a stage which we all should strive to attain. He was that template, that example. But Vishnu, Shiva, Devi are all concepts. The mega, the mini, the here and there, everything runs parallelly in Sanatana, Dharma, not religion. Religion, the minute you say religion, it gets something totally different.
I agree. So totally.
You get my point.
Absolutely. Very nicely put also by you. Ma'am, in India, we get a fair share of students who are coming from abroad to learn our art forms, music, art, culture, everything. But there is also this trend now which has begun that people who want to pursue music and dance, they want to study in the universities abroad. So how are you seeing this trend, ma'am? How do you
mean the Indian musicians and dancers?
No, Indian students who wish to learn music or dance forms, they prefer to go and learn in the foreign universities now. They would go to Berkeley, ma'am. They would go to Trinity.
No, I'm not sure how, what percentage. I'm not sure.
But there is a trend, ma'am. I mean, those who want to pursue, make music their profession, they now go. You also, of course, you are a visiting faculty in many of these universities also, ma'am, abroad. So do you see this? Or would you still say that this India remains the Mecca for all those who wish to learn dance?
No, India, Bharatavarsha remains the center point. I won't call it the what you called it.
Okay.
Center point, the Kendra Bindu, the heart. But there are artists and they should go and learn maybe how they do notations, write notations of Western dance choreographies. Because our choreographies cannot be written down the way, you know, it's here. You can just write guiding, you know, some pointers. But you cannot say, oh, she went off. My question. Ah, okay, she came back.
I'm
But
smiling because
musicians also want to go and hear and maybe learn some other instrument and bring that kind of knowledge or their practices into their music. But I think I won't call it a trend really. It's not become a trend. It may be a
No. It's very
why
expensive
not?
also. Everybody cannot afford it also. It's very, very frightfully expensive studying music and all. And in India, parents, as you have rightly said, you don't now think for educational academic stuff. Ma'am, I can't end this session unless and until I ask you, what is going to be the impact of this digital revolution which is sweeping us out on the cultural scene of India?
Hari
We
Om,
are
Hari Om. I still need Mr. Balan to connect me. Okay. The utmost I can do is to use my phone to receive and put emails and WhatsApp and messages and phone. Digital revolution, of course, is there. I think I will die before I see robots dancing and artists sitting and clapping. I don't want to live till then. But digital revolution, if you know how to use it, if you know how to use it, can be very helpful. But the minute you allow your WhatsApp or your mobile or your laptop or your digital whatever to master you, control you, then it's disastrous. So our own discipline, self-discipline, and our awareness, the control, each one has to do that. That exercise should be constant. Because as I said, information, there's so much, oh my, ye dekh lo, wo dekh lo, ha. And 24 hours are not enough. And then they say, we don't have time to remember anything. Oh my God. How come? I remember 300 choreographies and songs and tal and rags and everything. And I remember about the world politics and Russia and America and India and whatnot. I've been to 90 countries. I remember the names of the capitals. I mean, how? So, digital revolution should not make your brain, which is a muscle, to become a little walnut. Big danger there
Correct.
that you lose your physical faculties and you become so dependent on the machine which can let you down anytime. So these are the dangers. Positive, you have to use your own discipline, your needs, recognize them, and do everything with awareness.
Correct. True. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. It's such a pleasure always watching you. You are such a treasure to this country. And I hope we have many more sessions and I keep on interacting with you like this in the coming future also. Thank you so much.
Most
Thank you.
welcome. All the best. Bless you. Be
Thank
safe.
you.
Be happy. Be joyous.
You
God
too, ma'am.
bless.
You too. Thank you so much.
Just a minute. If you could allow me 1 minute, I would like to say something. As a 21-year-old, I speak for every youth who might be watching this, and I speak for myself as well. There were a few points that I was listening to, and when there was this one point where you asked whether the youth is today, interested or not. So I speak this for every one of us. The meetings might change, ma'am, but as far as I can see, someone like you, or both of you for that matter, in your respective fields coming in and putting forth your craft, I would go miles. I would not mind getting a new entire internet connection. I would I would not mind doing anything but to avail this, because right now while I was sitting here and I was listening to all everything, I mean, there were so many things going on in my mind, and I am walking out wiser. I'm walking out enriched. And there is one more point that I have to highlight, that there are three, four panels and links going on, you know, alternatively. But this one had no internet issue. And that is I guess it is an interesting fact. When the viewer really wants to listen and when the speaker really wants to take value, nothing can change and stop.
So how wonderful. I would like to all of you to go to my YouTube channel. And on 10th and 11th October, I did 2 days of virtual festival, Kalayatra 2020. 10th October was on Ramayana, different art forms, dance and lectures. And 11th October was on Mahabharata. I really want you all to visit that, see that, and if possible, convey to me, communicate with me. If you have questions or whatever you got from it, I'll be so happy.
Thank you. Definitely, ma'am, we're going to do that right away. Already on process.
Thank you. God bless.
Thank you. God bless. Both of you, thank you for telling me how power can exist with grace. I'm taking that back with me today. Thank you so much for both of you. And I'm just grateful, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye.